We have here a Model X key, and I have an issue, and I'm not the only one that has this issue. There seems to be defects with them. And the defect is, after a period of time, the keys will just kind of go into like a meltdown mode and start draining batteries anywhere from 20 minutes to overnight. Hi, Mina.
I'm back.
Yes, I know you're back. Daddy's doing video now. Say hi to everybody.
Hi.
Okay, now it's quiet time. Okay, shh. So, this was the one that was most recently replaced. For me, it seems to happen every year to the month. And I've been lucky a couple times that it failed within the 1 year period. So it was still under the warranty, key or service warranty of 1 year, 10,000 miles. Well, that was actually over 10,000 miles, but they just looked at the dates. Yay. This one was not, and I'm getting a little tired of paying about $200 in labor to have new keys programmed, because these are not cheap. And frankly, the Model X key sucks, specifically the side door buttons. Now, we're going to open this one up. It's not very difficult, but I got to remember how I did it. we're going to open it up, and then I'm going to put the battery in. And we're going to use my thermal, my FLIR thermal, which is running a little flaky right now because FLIR decided to plan obsolescence, the older FLIR cameras, by just 100% removing support from the app without any notification. And then they say, oh, too bad. We no longer support that device. You know, if we didn't update the app, it would have been fine for just about forever. So I will no longer buy a FLIR product because of that. Could be a class action lawsuit. Pissed a lot of people off. So took that off. Now, Vincent, quiet. Vinny, quiet. These are actually metal. Now, I did have this off, and unfortunately, I did lose one of the under buttons. I was trying to see with a high-powered magnifying glass if I could figure out where the short was or if there was a break or disconnect. And then I got the idea, why not try I lost that one. It's in my office somewhere in the dark colored carpet. So we can just look at this real quick here. We're going to zoom in with the main camera. And I'll get closer once with the thermal once we get to that point. That's the antenna for the Bluetooth transmission, because these operate based on Bluetooth. Front button, trunk button, and it also doubles as charge port opener. These little flaps on the sides are for the Falcon doors. And right there in the middle is the lock unlock button, and if you press and hold, summon. So let's see, gently get on there. Although on the previous ones, if I put a new battery in, it would still function for the 20 or so minutes that the battery would last. This one just completely, you know, dead. Now I did look at all these little circuits and pathways with my high-powered magnifying glass. It was like a 20x magnifying glass. Let's see. That's about as much as my 250 zoom camcorder will zoom in. And I saw zero breaks, zero melting. There's the bottom. I did peel the sticker off, the FCC sticker. This right here is a RFID coil. That's what allows you to still open the doors at certain reading points, which I've covered in other videos. I'll link in the description box. And that does not need power to function. All you do is hold that on specific spot on the car, and first it will unlock the doors, and then second, once you put it in a specific spot in the car, you can use it to actually start the car. Not recommended to rely on that, and if you do have to rely on that, take the battery out first, because having the battery in there can block some of that RFID, and I just found 9 out of 10 times it didn't work with the battery in, and about 8 out of 10 times it worked with the battery out. Okay, thank you, Mondly, reminding me that I need to work on my languages. Okay, so I guess we'll start at the top. I'm going to pull my thermal camera out here. We're going to zoom out on the main. And beautiful day outside here. Absolutely gorgeous. It's about 45 degrees out. I'm wearing sandals. I'm sitting on the porch. All right. Let's see if I can recalibrate. Okay. Like I said, this isn't working the best. I'm using kind of a hack workaround to even get this to work at all, because I do not feel like spending $500 to replace a working thermal camera just because FLIR decided to F everybody over. So F you, FLIR. That's it. I'm done. I will go to a cheap Chinese knockoff before I buy another one of your products. I can't even video record anymore. And they said, oh, it will still work with an iPhone 5S, which it was originally designed for. Well, when I try that, the app now just crashes, which did not do that prior to this update either. So anyways, I'm going to have to hold the battery in here. And this is a good battery. Wonder if I can... The FLIR one has two cameras. It has a regular optical camera and it has a thermal. And it combines the images to get a more detailed picture. So I'm trying to cover the optical with my finger so we don't get like a double image. Come on, come on, come on. There we go. What you're seeing there in the middle, right dead center there where it says 88 degrees, 90, that's actually the infrared reflection of my body heat off of a metal piece there. Doing the best I can. Because infrared is light, just on a wavelength humans can't see. You can see as I move it, the reflectiveness. I have to try that. Trying to wait for something to heat up here. It's gonna, brighter the color, the hotter it is. Calibrate. That looks to be the reflection of the Bluetooth antenna. Front button. Well, that's weird. I was expecting something to heat up, and yes, this battery is good. Unless I'm just not getting it on there good, but this is... I'm going to hold it. There's a component that's heating up. Should stay warm for at least a few seconds there. So all the chips. I'm trying to keep my hand away right now. And I'm on an angle that way it's not, my body heat's not reflecting off of anything shiny. Let's try again. It seems like everything overall is warming up. I was hoping to discover some sort of short. Well, that was a little disappointing. I really don't have a better way of doing this. I tried alligator clips, but I don't really have anything with the battery that would hold that thought. Let me get some tape in my alligator clips again. Sorry for the delay. Oh, crap. Now, my Model S keys, I have never had one fail in 10 years. All right. Negatory. Very well. My electrical tape does not appear to be very sticky. Okay. And if we're going to do that, I can take the sticker off because I won't have to worry about the battery shorting anything out now. No, I'm not being very delicate or scientific on this. Of course, I bent that tab a little too much. Doesn't matter, this key's junk now. So, do a recalibrate. And power. Nothing so far. Just some infrared reflection on the bottom side, which is up, it's upside down at the moment. Nothing that jumps out at me. Alright, let's gently flip it on its side. Where is it? There we go. Recalibrate. If the traditional Flare app still worked, those two images would have been combined better. Much more detailed picture. So strangely, I don't see a specific hot spot. It's almost like the whole key is just discharging power off. Considering that it's like 45 degrees out, though, it's not cooling off too quick. What is that? That's a bubble bottle. All right, well, I'm slightly disappointed. I'm slightly disappointed because I was expecting something to be heating up to be able to drain these batteries. Maybe it's just the whole thing shorted out. All right, we're done with thermal. Let's take a quick look now. All right, give up on that. Zoom in, take a quick look. Well, we've already looked at just about everything. This was made in... don't see it now. Yep. Normal Tesla has to overcomplicate something. Hey, now, I don't know if... I have considered this. If my current key lasts past the warranty period, I have a nasty problem of pocket pressing the Falcon Wing doors because those buttons press really easily. And it's happened in rainstorm. It's happened in snowstorm. It's just happened randomly where I've pocket pressed the key fob and opened the Falcon doors and didn't realize it until I had a ton of snow inside the car or lots of rain. If you so desired, you could snip focus. You could snip the buttons off. And then you wouldn't have to, obviously you would no longer be able to open the Falcon doors from the key. Kind of nice because they open so dang slow. But at the same time, if you're someone like me with that pocket presses them constantly, that might be a good solution for you. And if my current key lasts longer than a year, I am going to do that. Because I'm sure pocket pressing the buttons in my pocket does nothing good for these relatively expensive batteries. I mean, they couldn't have just used the standard CR2032 like pretty much every other key fob in the world, but instead they use a CR2354. Whereas I can get a 10 pack of CR2302 for about $3. These cost about $5 each, and there's a lot of knockoffs that will actually damage your fob. So only get the genuine Panasonic from a reputable retailer like Walmart or Batteries Plus Bulbs. And that's it. That's a Model X key fob there. So I'm going to put it back together now, and this is just going to go on my Tesla wall, along with all the Matchbox Tesla cars. Bye-bye.